Closer, be real, that's over the mall. This the last play, I'm holding the ball. Now we raise the trophy, you frozen in awe. Yeah, we the champions, we passing them, no, we laughing them. Play a beat for me, I'm attacking it. One thing you.
Sharif Allman, Be Real Entertainment. I just want to say thank you, everybody, for watching. Today, I'm just going to do a shout out to the Navy, the Coast Guard, U.S. Marines, the Air Force, the Army, Navy SEALs. A lot of you guys went out there, you know, because you wanted to fight for our country, which is great. And a lot of you guys went out there because you guys didn't know where you wanted to go in life. You didn't know what you wanted to do. You're stuck. Your home life wasn't great. You financially weren't stable. You weren't doing so well in school. But what you didn't realize, what I believe deep down inside, is that you guys wind up going out there, and you guys wind up going out there for yourselves at the first start. But then, you guys wind up going out there and saving thousands of people. So I just want to say thank you, because those who went out there because they wanted to fight for our country, I really thank you for that.
So proud of my husband. I'm very, very proud of his work and everything that he...
Those of you who went out there, didn't know what you wanted to do in life, didn't know where you're going, so you thought you'd just go out there. You went out there for yourself at the beginning, but then at the end, if you really look at it, you guys went out there and you're fighting for everybody, meaning you're fighting for people you don't know, meaning you're not selfish to begin with. You're thinking about others. And I hope you find that out along the way of your path. You went out there for a reason. You signed up for a reason. So I just want you to remember, when you're there and you're struggling and you don't want to go no more, or you physically can't go no more, take a look back on the reason why you're out there. Because I don't know what it's going to be like, but I have a feeling you're going to want to lose faith at one point. And just remember, have faith in something, whether it's yourself, whether it's a religion. Like I said, I love to say I don't know. I'm not going to sit here and say I know what it's like. I don't know what it's like. I don't know what goes through your guys' minds, you know, over there in Afghanistan. But like I said, whatever you see, I just hope you take it and use it as a living and learning tool. I hope you live through it, experience it, and you learn from it. And you bless people with your experience. That way they know what they're getting themselves into, or they really know about those people. Because a lot of people think over there in Afghanistan everybody's the same. But you guys know, those of you who are true to yourselves and true to what you see, you guys know that all those people over there are really good people. Just because a few ignorant people or a few people who like to do other things doesn't mean they're all like that. And you guys get to see that. So I just hope you guys bless people with sharing that everybody over there is not the same and has the same mentality. Feeling there's gonna be times when you guys just really want to give up, you guys have no hope, you know, you guys are probably down and out, and it's gonna be really, really stressing. You guys have somebody yelling in your face. But like I said, I just want you to remember, you started, finish. I know that's easy for me to say because I haven't been through it yet, but I just want to say, if you're in boot camp right now and you know you're on that I want to go home, I can't do this, really think why you got there. Why did you get there? I'm asking you right now. Think. I'll wait. I really want you to think. Why are you here? Is it for money? Is it for to fight for your country? Do you have a daughter home? Do you have a wife that's sitting at home waiting for you? What do you have at home? If you don't have nothing at home, then what are you doing here? Do you feel like you got something here? And if you do feel like you got something here because you don't have something back at home, then why not stay here and conquer what you came here for? Like I said, I don't know what it's like. I wake up every morning, make stupid videos, make you guys laugh. You guys are waking up to somebody yelling in your face. But I just wanted to try to say, you can do anything you really put your mind to. I believe in that deeply. You can mentally think it, and you can physically go out and do it. That's just me, though. But what do I know? I'm just some kid who's kind of decent looking, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Kind of cute, you know what I'm saying? No. If you're a homosexual, that's who you are. You can't change who you are. Don't let anybody knock who you are, because if you listen to them and you start listening to their ways and you're changing yourself, then you're not being yourself. If you're a homosexual going into it, be a homosexual going into it. Just because you're a homosexual, does that mean you can't do push-ups the same? Does that mean you can't climb through mud the same? No, it doesn't mean at all. So don't have no fear of being a homosexual and say, oh, well, what if they think this, or, you know, what people stare at me? People are always gonna stare at you. That's why we got eyes. You know what I'm saying? People stare at me, look at me, I'm gorgeous. Now, single 4 years, I must not be that gorgeous. And to my women out there, don't ever let nobody ever tell you you can't do anything. Look at me. I don't care what anybody tells you. I really don't. You're out there, you're out there. You're gonna do everything the men do. Whether it's push-ups, whether it's sit-ups, whether it's climbing over a wall. In Afghanistan, not showering like the men do, you're out there to prove a point to somebody. I don't know who the point you're trying to prove to is, but you're trying to prove a point to somebody. Put the glass back on. Or don't step down a level because you're like, oh, I'm out here with guys and they're better. No, I don't want you to have that mentality. Once you're out there, you're out there. You're not under anybody. If anything, you're gonna get above everybody and show the guys that you're way better than them. As soon as you step down, then what? Why are you gonna step back up? Once you step back up, you're at the same place you left off. So don't even think about stepping down. Keep stepping up from that one level you're at. Because once you go down a level, it doesn't make sense to go, I'm up a level. But this level now that I'm up at was the level where I had no faith in myself and I stepped back down.
It's worth it, like, oh my God.
Go straight up, don't stop. I don't care if, you know, guys are looking at you or, you know, your friends or even your family are telling you, oh, you're not gonna make it out there, you're not gonna make it. You will make it once you have faith in yourself. My dad just passed away. It's a very tragic story. Sharif Ahmed Sr., rest in peace. I love you, Dad. He's right here. People ask me, why am I not devastated? Why don't I sit, you know, at home and cry? Why don't I shut off the world? What's shutting off the world gonna do? It's not gonna do anything. Because if you think about it, if I shut off the world, if I stay at home and cry, who am I benefiting? Life, I believe, is a live, learn experience. You live through it. I live through my dad's experience. It's very different. It's not a normal death. It's not dying of old age. It's pretty tragic. But I lived through it, and now I'm going to learn from it. I learned that you should talk to people. You never outcast people because you never know. Somebody would have talked to my dad that day, maybe his mind would have changed. Somebody would have talked to him that week, maybe his mind would have changed. Like I said, you guys, live and learn through whatever your experience is. Like I said, if you're a homosexual, a man, a woman, somebody rich, a nobody, poor, whatever it is, where are you now? You're out there at that boot camp with everybody else that's not higher than you yet. And the only reason why they'll be higher than you is because they worked harder and they had the mental positivity to get them where they are. But right now, you guys are all balanced the same. Nobody's higher, nobody's richer, nobody's poor, nobody's less. Everybody has the same thing, a beating heart. The graduation day is just gonna make you look and go, I did everything everybody said I could do. I did everything I said I couldn't do. I was being real with myself. I hope you realize that at the end, that all you have to do is be real. Our nation, your dedication gets you to that great, great graduation.
Gorillas in suits, the holy war, the spiritual troops, fighting over the mythical truth, drowning in the political soup. They shoot missiles and nukes, taking out such a pivotal group. The body count is the physical proof, and they thought drugs were killing the youth. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you all.